Now we know that chest pain is the most common sign and symptom for heart attacks for both men and women, but did you know that women may be more likely to have other symptoms than men that represent a heart attack? Well, I don't know if you knew that. If you did, that's awesome. If you didn't, you're in the right place because that's what we're talking about today. We're talking about these exact very symptoms you need to be on the lookout for, the atypical symptoms that women may have, which might signal a heart attack. Guys, I'm Dr. Jen Caudle. I'm a practicing family physician and on-air health expert and a video creator. Welcome to my channel. If you're interested in health news, all sorts of health stuff, also COVID health information, please subscribe to my channel. Also, click the little bell to get updates. So it is Ladies' Day here, or Ladies' Night, rather, I should say. Well, that is, we're talking about the ladies in particular today, and particular signs and symptoms of heart attacks that we might see in women. Now, this is, of course, for the ladies, but for all the men who have ladies in your lives. And I'm wearing red right now for Heart Month, which is February, because this is a really important time to talk about this very, very important topic. Now, chest pain, yes, we know chest pain is sort of the universal sign for heart attack, right? That's what we think about, rather, when we think of chest pain. But, you know, you got to remember, and we have to remind ourselves, that women may not have chest pains. We know that women are more likely than men to have other symptoms that actually may be signaling a heart attack. Guys, these are so important to note. And I guess one of the big things, and one of the reasons why I'm going through this, I'm going to give you the symptoms in a minute, is because I want you to trust your bodies. I want you to trust yourself. If something is not right, seek help. But here are the symptoms that women may experience. First of all, now, the chest pain stuff, but that could also be, maybe not just chest pain, could be a pressure or a squeezing feeling in the center of the chest, or fullness that you experience in the center of the chest as well. It could be not involving the chest at all. It could be pain in one or both of your arms. It could also be pain in your back, in your neck, in your jaw or your stomach. Now that one, guys, don't blow that one off. It's super, super important. I've actually had patients who had heart attacks, and the symptoms that they had were not chest pain, but they had stomach pain, or they had arm pain, or they had neck pain, or back pain, or jaw pain. These things can be real. So once again, if you have symptoms that you don't understand, that don't make sense for you, that are not right, make sure you get an answer to them. But that's not all when it comes to potential atypical symptoms for heart attacks. Other signs include breaking out into a cold sweat, feeling nauseous or lightheadedness. That's right. And sometimes with that nausea comes vomiting. Once again, none of these symptoms have anything to do specifically with chest pains. Some people just get cold sweats, cold and clammy, nausea, vomiting, lightheadedness. Also, some people may actually just get shortness of breath. That's right. No pain, just, oh my gosh, I can't catch my breath. Feeling short of breath, okay? Now, these symptoms are, I'm not telling you these to scare you. What I'm telling you is that, you know, the signs and the symptoms of a heart attack may not only be just chest pains. It can range and be a number of symptoms. The bottom line here is for you to trust yourself, trust your body. You know your body best. And I always say, as I did earlier in this video, if something doesn't seem right, make sure you get it checked out. Guys, there's also a lot of things that we can do to make sure we improve our heart health. And I'd be remiss if I didn't throw this stuff in there. This is not an all-inclusive list, just a few things to remind yourself to do that we should all be doing, which is making sure that we're not smoking, quitting smoking if we do smoke, making sure that we're keeping a healthy weight, that we're exercising, eating a healthy diet, we're keeping any chronic medical conditions in control. That means any diabetes, high blood pressure, cholesterol, keeping that in control. I also say knowing your family history is super, super, super important. Taking medications that we need to take as prescribed. There are other things that we can do to keep our heart healthy, but those things at least are a good start. Guys, I hope this is helpful. And hooray for Heart Month. I love it. Ladies, always trying to keep you safe, and men trying to keep the ladies in your lives safe as well as you. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I'm Dr. Jen Caudle. If you're interested in more content like this, please subscribe to my channel and click the little bell to get updates. Also, please consider joining my membership groups for lots of perks. Guys, I will see you soon.